Well, it was anything but pretty for Peter Wright, who missed 8 darts at a double in the final leg, but he finally, after what felt like an age, hit double 5 to secure a 6-4 victory over Joe Huffman. And hard fought, and we've seen much better numbers from other players this evening, but he's got the crucial, all-important W next to his name, Alex.
Well, that's all that matters at the end of the day, certainly in this round, but you won't want to see a video of that. I mean, there was a lot of bad points in the whole of that match there, certainly the doubles at the end. But again, he's changed his darts. We were talking about it in the mid-session there. And they were going in at a very strange angle because Peter's darts used to all stand up quite a bit. And
why does he keep changing them? Well, what's the reason behind that?
Well, initially, when you're playing well, you don't notice it because it's fine. But when you're not playing well or you start losing, that's when everybody will challenge you, why do you keep changing them all the time? He almost used to feel, didn't he, that he could get another few percent by changing a flight or a stem or something. But obviously on this occasion, it hasn't worked.
It can't be that common for darts players to change their darts, whatever it may be about their darts, with such regularity that Peter does.
Yeah, I don't know of anybody. I mean, the big one I remember was Phil Taylor, threw very much with a traditional Eric Bristow dart, then went with one with slightly more grip on, and then completely changed the style of barrel from a long, thin dart to almost like a fat John Lowe type dart. But the majority, Michael Van Gerwen's got the same darts he's been using since he was about 14 years of age. Mm. I use the same darts pretty much throughout my whole career. Even when you go with a different manufacturer, they're just effectively a copy. They were going in at terrible angles. They were blocking the bed. It's different if they go in and how they line the board. You know, Phil used to, the darts would go in at that angle, which would leave the bed open. So it was an open target. But when they start going in that way and that way, then it's just a completely blocked target.
Right, our final match of the evening features Daryl Gurney, who was runner-up in this tournament 12 months ago behind Michael Van Gerwen. And he's been on social media today saying how much he's looking forward to being back on this stage. What chance do we give him? What can we expect from Daryl tonight?
Well, this kind of launched him last year and he loved it, so he'll be looking forward to the challenge and being up there and no doubt hopefully trying to do better than he did last year. He's a superb player, Daryl. I like him a lot. I like his game. I like his attitude and his aggression. He just needs to really get back to the standard he got when he won the Grand Prix.
Yeah, big stage player. Loves playing on the big stage. Loves playing on TV. This is a nice opening game for him. He would have seen John Norman's antics against Dawson Michel yesterday, and he'll quite like that bit of confrontation. It tends to spur him on a little bit. When it gets a little bit tasty, he tends to produce the goods a little bit more often.
Yeah, he's walking out. You might be able to pick it up in the background to Johnny B. Good, unsurprisingly. That is John Norman Jr., who made the final of the North American Championships last night, making his way out onto the stage. It is time for us to cross to the Mandalay Bay for the final time tonight. It is last year's US Masters finalist Daryl Gurney against, as I mentioned, last night's North American finalist John Norman Jr. This should be a good one to round off proceedings on day one of the US Darts Masters. Let's take you for the final time to the Mandalay Bay Hotel and rejoin our MC, John McDonald.
He's the reigning World Grand Prix champion, Super Chief!
One more spot left in the quarterfinals up for grabs, and it goes to either the runner-up from last year at the US Darts Masters, the world number six, Daryl Gurney, or the runner-up from yesterday's North American Championship, John Norman Jr. Final game of the night. Superchin and Junior. And alongside me in the commentary box, the only man, it seems, in the Mandalay Bay Resort who didn't plant a kiss on John Norman Jr. on his way to the stage, Stuart Pike.
Oh, thank you, yes. Daryl Gurney, who's enjoying the delights of the Cirque du Soleil, Michael Jackson, last night. His preparation for today's match. Social media is all about getting back to business for Superchin. John Norman Jr. caused a bit of controversy in his semi-final win over Dawson Mercer in the North American Championship yesterday, with his aptly described sumo shout in the face of his young opponent after winning. I would suggest he doesn't do that to Daryl Gurney.
It is fair to say that these two's on-stage personas divide opinion. Daryl Gurney went all the way to the Grand Prix title, of course, his first major title last year, 2017, a year where things really started to happen for Superchin, regularly in the semi-finals and finals of the big TV tournaments, winning titles away from their cameras, won that Grand Prix title, and of course, it was here in Vegas where he made it all the way to the final, beating Peter Wright, Gary Anderson, playing fabulous darts all the way through the tournament. Didn't average less than 96 England over his four games.
Fidley, hey, Darryl to throw first.
He nearly beat Michael Van Gerwen as well. It was 8-6, if memory serves me, in that final. And Gurney had chances late on to go ahead. We were just talking off air before the walk-ons about Gurney's recent fall, which hasn't been the best.
No, not as good as it was last year. There have still been moments, and he's still found his way through to quarterfinals and semi-finals and various events. He has made one final this year as well, but you're going back a few months, the last, pretty much since the World Cup of Darts,
140.
Which took place in Germany at the start of last month. It's just been a bit tired looking.
Yeah, patchy, very much so. Another of our top dart stars who will soon become a dad for the first time.
95.
Unfortunate. For the world number five.
Had a very decent Premier League campaign, Daryl Gurney. So I think that's probably got to be taken into account. We did talk early on about Rob Cross and how the demands of being a Premier League player was something new he had to contend with. And we hear Superchin, Superchin. Now this was the anthem pretty much of last year's US Darts Masters as Superchin carved his way through the field. Vegas fans really took to Daryl Gurney.
Darryl Ugon, 96.
Double 18 for a comfortable hold of throw in the opening leg.
The first leg, Daryl Gurney.
Nice 14 darts.
First, game on.
Now losing the final of the North American Championship to Jeff Smith. Smith unfortunate to
61.
Draw Michael Van Gerwen. Run into Michael Van Gerwen earlier today. Didn't win a leg against a defending US Masters champ.
60.
That was a big disappointment, I think. You know, for any of the North American players who come here for the week and get through the qualifiers, their aim is to win a place at the World Championship. Only one can. But when you get so close as Norman Jr. did. When it's a play, the number one seed, Peter Wright, you just scrape through if you are just joining us, beating Joseph Huffman 6-4.
$100.
Last year, Gurney began by seeing off DJ Sayre. And then it was Peter Wright. DJ Sayre powerless to stop Gary Anderson, who has been the standout performer of the opening day of action here in Vegas. 112.63 average.
Effortless, wasn't it?
Only seen three averages higher than that in the history of the World Series of Darts. Cannot do it. One of those frustrating ones where John Norman Jr., if that dart fell out the board just then, he suddenly could finish it. But he looked pretty sturdy, so he wasn't going to hang around and wait.
So
32 for the Canadian. To level up this last first round match.
And so on the second leg, John Norman Jr. Well, look at Darryl to throw first. Game.
Well, he's brought some fans with him.
140.
Still waiting for the first 180 in this one. Get Darryl Gurney hit more 180s than anybody else over the course of the Premier League season this year. He is an enormous scorer when he gets going.
108!
But that is the first one, and it comes from the Canadian.
Well, earlier today we saw Gary Anderson hit seven perfect darts, missed the treble 19. We've seen Mike hit six perfect darts.
So,
he's left 81 after nine darts here against the throw of the world number five. That's all right, 20 for tops.
41.
Right on the top wire.
101.
Pressure on Gurney. Treble 18 the shot. Tops the shot.
Yeah, well, there you have it. Leg.
John Norman Jr. had one dart at the tops.
Game on.
Darryl Gurney gets one dart at tops. Hold the pose, son. Hold the pose.
A rescue act, that treble 18 and double top from Darryl Gurney.
96.
And a strong start to this one from John Norman Jr. And look, the North American players,
400.
Obviously Orson Dawson managed to come through his game earlier on against Gerwin Price. And all right, he took out some important shots at the right times, but he's not played his best in that game. We haven't seen anybody really step up from the North American contingent and firing those 100 averages, which they have been doing sporadically in the qualifiers. We know the game is there. Can they unlock it on the big stage against the big guns? Because right now, John Norman Jr. is doing so.
$105.
Oh, played really well. Gurney being forced to play really well.
100. Johnny Maguire, 120.
Oh, he missed tops in the last leg.
Yeah,
no problem here.
John Norman Jr.
It's a terrific leg again for John Norman Jr. Gurney averaging 100. The Canadian averaging 103. We've seen some great finishing, 120 from Norman Jr. Gurney, a 96, two dart finish and a 101 finish to win his two legs so far.
Eighty-three.
John Norman Jr. did play pretty much half the events last year 30. On the tour. Took a year off work. Keep flying over to the UK and playing all these ranked events behind closed doors in places like Wigan and Barnsley.
58.
And he picked up the odd win here and there. Perhaps the most significant one he had was against the Diamond Ian White, a top 16 player and a guy who's won nearly 10 PDC ranking titles. But he didn't get past the third round in any of those tournaments.
46.
But he's throwing darts here that suggest he is in with a shot. He has got more than a puncher's chance of being able to take a huge 64. Name casualty.
It'll be also noticeable that the quality, the standard of the North American players has improved vastly in the 12 months since we were here.
46. Sixty. Darryl Uruguay, 145.
Treble 19 or treble 15. He goes for the treble 19 for the double 14. What a fantastic shot from Dan Gurney. 96, 101, 145. We've seen 120 from his opponent. Masterclass.
And all John Norman Jr. could do there was watch the Gurney celebration with a slightly
100.
Sort of baffled smirk on his face. This is the biggest 180 hitter in the Premier League this year. He hasn't hit a maximum yet, but it's
96.
The finishing that has been superb. 100% on the doubles, with Gurney checking out 96, 101, 145. Norman Jr.'s not been bad himself.
Well, between them, 5 out of 6 on the doubles. The only missed dart came from the Canadian. You may remember he missed tops to break the throw in leg 3.
59.
It's a significant miss. Can he find a way through to the treble?
60.
Nailed on first 180 for Gurney.
180.
An inevitability about it. When he gets those massive long javelins in the right bit of the treble 20 bed,
60.
It becomes difficult for him to miss sometimes.
Another treble.
130.
That's okay. Put pressure on Gurley. Looking for the break and throw. One dart. Oh, what a good marker that is. Had to be, didn't it?
Yeah,
I'm pretty sure that's not where he meant that first dart of the single 16 to go. It was the perfect dart to set up the perfect double. And the first break of throw.
Absolutely textbook stuff from Darryl Gurney there. And that double 16, very, very strong in that
95.
Area of the board. It is perhaps the most important factor from the Grand Prix of last year, where he was hitting it 50% of the time to start legs and often to end legs.
With four out of four of the doubles.
100.
It was an exhibition of scoring from Gary Anderson. 5 180s in his 6-1 win earlier on.
60.
Rob Cross and Michael Van Gerwen gave us a bit of everything, but this is world-class finishing from the World Grand Prix champion, Darryl Gurney.
Identical, really. In the last leg, he hit a 180 to lead 166.
Well, John Norman Jr. will be getting a sinking feeling if he sees Darryl Gurney reach the numbers 3, 4, 6 again at some point. This time he finds another treble.
32 after 12 for the Irishman. Well, number 5 has stepped it up when it's really mattered, hasn't he?
140.
180 wins leg. 180 wins leg. Three legs on the spin.
I think it's John to throw first.
Three brilliant legs of darts.
But he has missed the dart at double. Although it didn't really matter because he took out the very next one in the same visit. So, effectively, John Norman Jr. has not benefited at all.
140.
And Darryl Gurney, having averaged more than 96 and a couple of times over 100 in last year's US Darts Masters in his run to the final.
Looks like he might do something similar. Unlucky. Yeah, was unlucky. But he's played well, the Canadian. He really has. That one missed dart at tops in the third leg has made all the difference.
140.
To the match. It really has. Since then, Gurney's taken control. That 101 finish turned it around.
Oh, not much difference there, is there?
140.
That trio of ton 40s for John Norman Jr. leaving 81 after 9.
57. Johnny Maguire, 81.
Darryl Gurney has the safety net of knowing that he's going to get two bites of the cherry of throwing for the match if he needs them. Is he going to go for the ball? Yeah,
56.
Why not with your opponent back on 184?
$134, 25.
You went for the ball, John. You only hit the 25. Was it wise?
$17.
Hindsight's a wonderful thing, Pikey.
I don't think he did the right thing. You wanted to go for it. And that's okay. I don't think it's going to make too much difference to the outcome of the game whether Gurney wins in this leg or the next leg.
Yeah,
but he does win in this leg. Four legs on the spin for last year's runner-up here in Las Vegas. Darryl Gurney with a terrific performance. 6 out of 8 on the doubles. And an average of just shy of 100. And Darryl Gurney sets up a quarter-final showdown with the number one seed, Peter Wright.
in Vegas at Mandalay Bay on Saturday.
Well, last year's runner-up, Daryl Gurney, has made his way through to the quarterfinals, and here is how it looks. Tomorrow's action, Michael Smith against Rob Cross, James Wade against Michael Van Gerwen. Gary Anderson will take on Dawson Michel, who provided the upset of the night against Gerwen Price. And Peter Wright taking on Daryl Gurney, who we have just seen defeat John Norman Jr. Just a quick line on Daryl's performance there.
Good test for him. That's an ideal scenario. A 6-0 sort of blast out wouldn't have done him any good, but that set him up well for tomorrow against Peter Wright. He had to throw some high quality darts there.
He did, yeah. John Norman really pushed him all the way. I was really impressed with where John played there. Might sort of spur him on with it being a tour card holder to go to a few more tournaments.
Best of all the Americans, or the Canadian, the best performance so far by anybody.
John's?
Yeah.
He played in the World Cup of Darts, didn't he, last year with John Parr, very charismatic, and he's put up a good performance in defeat behind Gary Anderson there. Arguably, there's no arguments about it. The performance of the night's come from Gary Anderson, 112 average, Alan.
Yeah, outstanding, yeah. It was great to watch. Good to see Gary in good form, and when he's in that form, he's irresistible to watch, he really is.
You fancy him to win this, didn't
you? I said
that
at the start. I just got that feeling with Gary. You've got to kind of know the character, and he likes this kind of format and where it is. He loves it over in Vegas, he's enjoying himself, and that tends to be when he plays his best darts.
And you said actually immediately afterwards, when we look at the form he's bringing into this event this season, I think it's five ranking tournaments he's won in 2018, you think he's throwing as well as ever?
Yeah, he's doing the Pro Tour, but he doesn't do the European Tour because he feels that he's away too much already anyway, and it works for him. He loves doing the World Series, plays all the TV events obviously, and keeps himself just that little bit hungry by doing the Pro Tour with the Players' Championship events.
He has nothing else to prove. You know, he's won the Premier League, he won back-to-back Worlds, he's won Pro Tour events. The one thing that sort of has eluded him is the World Match Play, but it's funny because that's the Vegas of the North and he hates it. I think the best he's ever done at the Match Play is the semi-final. Majority of the time he's gone out first or second round, I think. But yeah, he's in great form, and like I said before the match, he loves Vegas, he loves that environment, as Alan said, he loves the format, and he's going to be, if he carries on in that form, I don't think there's only one winner.
Gary Anderson loves Vegas, so does Dawson Michel. Last year caused the upset, beating James Wade, and he's done the same this time round, beating Gerwen Price.
Yeah, revisited again for awesome Dawson. You know, I said earlier on, I was so pleased that he got away out of his mind the defeat from yesterday, because that really took a big knock out of his system, but that has done him a lot of good. He played really well, he enjoys being up there, you can see him, you know, giving it all to the crowd there, and he loves the part, he loves being up there, and he wants to be there more often.
He plays Gary Anderson in the next chapter. Yeah. We'll have to ramp it up a little bit.
I think there was nearly 30 points difference in their averages, and it looks on paper to be a one-sided affair, but as we know, we nearly seen Wadey go out earlier. We've seen some good examinations of the players tonight, but for me, Gary Anderson was standout, and Rob Cross, don't write him off, because that was a solid performance.
10-plus averages from Michael Van Gerwen, and I'll get your thoughts on that in a moment, but Rob Cross played well as well.
Yeah, nearly 106 average, and his game's just starting to come together nicely now, and that's all off the back of one great weekend on the Pro Tour, winning one, runner-up the next day. That's give him the confidence that he needed.
Where do you think Rob Cross is at, Alan? I know you know him well.
I think he's in a bit of a change at the moment, because he found it really difficult, and people probably won't understand the fact that, you know, he was going away Wednesday morning and not getting home till Monday night on week in, week out, because of the Premier League commitments of being world champion, and plus all the other tournaments, which is fine, it's a good place to be in. But it took him a real long time to get used to that. He's just kind of got used to it. He's got himself a bit of a fitness regime. He's a great lad. I really like him a lot. He's thinking about his game already, even being world champion, which is good to see. Mm. for a lot of other people to have a look at. That you, even when you're at the top, you've still got to look at your game and try and improve.
He was on sort of burnout after his feet didn't touch the ground for 2 weeks after winning the World Championships, and I think it's taken him this long to recover.
Well, he's playing badminton every week now as well. We heard that in commentary. So Rob Cross very much back in the big leagues, and another good performance from him. Just a quick line on MVG. What did you make of his performance tonight?
Outstanding start. Was always going to win it after the first two or three legs. I mean, two maximums in the first two visits just shows you what he can do. And got over the line eventually quite easy against Jeff. Was unfortunate today. Still happy about yesterday, but Michael was outstanding. Mm.
Let's have a look at the order of play for tomorrow. Very much looking forward to this. Michael van Gerwen won this inaugural tournament 12 months ago. And here is how it will unfold tomorrow. The quarterfinal will kick off with Rob Cross against Michael Smith. Peter Wright against Daryl Gurney will be the second match that we see. Gary Anderson against Dawson Michelle, and then Michael van Gerwen against James Wade. Very quickly, what can we expect tomorrow?
A repeat of the World Championships match between Cross and Smith, where Smith actually had a dart or two darts to knock out Rob Cross in the Worlds.
One of the best matches of the tournament.
Yeah, it was fabulous. So if they serve up anything like the Worlds, then we're in for a treat.
And then we've got Michael and Gary, and you just never know what they're going to do. They could just absolutely hit anything.
Well, that's to look forward to tomorrow. I hope you can join us, because loads of good darts coming your way. We're back tomorrow night here on ITV. 4 for